and welcome back to the channel. I am Skinny. I am a director and a portrait photographer that specializes in lifestyle and fashion photography. In this video, we are shooting my friend Azima Ramsey, who is a classical violinist who fuses hip-hop into her music. In this shoot, we are taking you behind the scenes of an extended video where we turned Prospect Park, which is a local park here in Brooklyn, New York, into a full-on concert set. I'm a huge fan of live music. I love the feel that you get while watching it. I love all of the lights that they have in the background. I love the smoke, the fog machine, the ambiance. I love the feel of it. So it started as a photo shoot request and it ended up being an entire video production.
This all came together through love and friendship and just good vibes. I hit up Skinny and I was like, Skinny, can you please shoot me? And then it turned into this big production because it's of course Skinny, and here we are. So let's do this.
If we're gonna do all of the work as far as setting up the lighting and the location scouting, you might as well get the most bang for your buck. So with that being said, let me break down how we shot this video and also show you some of the stills that we were able to capture as well. So to start, you guys know that I love experimenting with, I want to say, inexpensive gear, because I believe that once you have the basics as far as gear goes, then just simple additions will help you along the way. There are some RGB LED panels that look very similar to the GVM video lights that I picked up from Amazon for about, I want to say, less than $100. They come two panels to a set. They are RGB, they are dimmable, and they're 100 watts. So that's a lot of output for something that is super inexpensive. And I figured that this was the perfect time to give it a try. For the location in Prospect Park, there is a gigantic tree where the limbs just extend far out. So when you're using a very wide angle lens, it will give the perception of this tree just being larger than life, which it pretty much is. When using the right lighting for this setup, it can actually enhance those features of this tree, but also give it a much different feel than when you see it during the daytime. We also chose to shoot at night so that we can control the lighting, and then also there's a lot less foot traffic in that part of the park during that time. So for lighting, we are using two RGB LED panels, and we are also adding in a dimmer that you can pick up from Amazon. It's a dimmer that you would attach to your porch light. It is remote controllable. It also has light functions, so it can have flash, it can have slow strobes, it can have broken TV, that sort of effect. And we were able to utilize that with these RGB panels. With the dimmer and the panels together, I'm probably looking at $120 in lighting. I also brought out two of the Young Nuo LED lights that run off of these NP batteries. And the reason I use that is because they're super lightweight. I figured that because it was dark, they're powerful enough for me to use them at night. And what I did was I added one to the tree to add as a backlight. And the second one I used as a key light going through a shoot through umbrella. Going through the shoot through umbrella was actually really simple. It's usually how I shoot my portraits when I'm using strobes. So using this with the LED light, I knew that it would give us beauty light for what we are shooting. It's also flattering, and because of the size of the source in comparison to the subject, it made Azima's skin glow, and it also makes her pop from the background. For some of the stills, I also used a Canon pocket flash with some pocket wizards just because it is super lightweight, it's nighttime, you don't really need a lot of power to capture great portraits in that setting. The other key piece to this was utilizing the homemade bug fogger with the mineral oil inside. So this gave us a ton of smoke. It was long lasting, it made the lights glow, and it also gave us this very ethereal feel. And it almost made it feel like an enchanted forest that's, you know, right in the middle of Brooklyn. For equipment, I'm using the Sony a7 III with the Sigma 35mm 1.4 art lens. I'm also using a star filter on that lens. It's giving us that twinkle from the background, and it pops in a specific way. When there are no lights that are specular, it actually feels like a ProMist filter, so it's actually serving two purposes at that point. The other camera that I'm using at that time is the Sony a6500 with the Sigma 16mm 1.4 lens. We also have a star filter on that as well. So for this shoot, we captured multiple takes at various focal lengths. So there are certain parts in the song where the beat gets a little bit more dramatic, where the music gets a little bit more moody, and I wanted the lighting to complement each of those sections. So what I did was record 3 separate takes, clean straight through with no special effects for lighting. On the second and third take, we added in some smoke, you know, some strobing light effects. When the song became dramatic, we had the lights flashing in blue or red. There are some close-ups that we grabbed of the violin and her face and just her expression for some of the detail shots so that we can break up the editing. And we used the fog machine to also accentuate that eerie feel or that ethereal environment. One thing that people severely underestimate during a shoot like this is the wardrobe and how much it plays a part in the final product.
So we are here today shooting and styling the amazing Ezzy. Right now her top is from Under Celeste, and she also has a beautiful look that we're doing made from Aliette. So shout out to Jason Rembert for that. You're amazing. So yeah.
Earrings.
My mistake. And jewelry, of course, is by Opal Stone Fine Jewelry. So we have this amazing pear drop earring going on here. And then we're gonna showcase a really dope Lady in the Frame earring later. So it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good.
So for this, we had my friend Lita styling this shoot. She tapped into a few local designers that are people of color. They allowed us to borrow some of their pieces to help us bring this story to life. So you can see how drastically that affects the look and feel of this shoot. So by elevating the outfits, you elevate the scene, and by elevating both of those things together, the production value goes through the roof. You know, for a set of RGB LED lights that were, you know, less than $100 and a great location, and a small team, we were able to pull this together and have a great time in Prospect Park. So some words of advice is to always make sure you're recording multiple takes of these performances. Grab them in various lengths, grab some detail shots, grab some tight shots of the face, grab some wide shots that show the location, and then while you're editing, you will thank yourself because you have options to choose from. The editing process of this was fairly simple. I actually used the multicam editing tool in Final Cut Pro, and all you have to do is actually click on all of the files that you are going to sync, and it will put them in viewer forms where you can select camera 1, 2, 3, 4, through 6, through 9, however many cams you have, and basically it will align itself with the section of the song. So once it does that, you just simply pick your favorite angle. You can even add transitions in to those different cuts later on. So you can actually see all of the angles that are playing for that part of the song at once, and you're basically editing to the song while it's playing. It's a really cool feature that not a lot of people talk about. It's actually one of the easiest ways to edit the music video because you can always add B-roll on top of that if you need to, and it is very efficient. So I recommend doing that. If you guys would like to see a breakdown of how that's done, I can do that as well. And if you have any questions, please leave comments below. Hit me up on Instagram at skinnywashere. And I hope to see you guys soon. Please be safe, be healthy, stay warm, and keep creating. Peace.